Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to use OpenAI API with Python, as well as I will be showing you how to create a REST API using Flask and Python and send a request from Postman and getting a response over here. So let's get started. First thing, just Google OpenAI API and make sure that you're already having an OpenAI account or a ChatGPT account. So click here. So here we will be having this API reference option. Open it in a new tab, and here you'll be having introduction. Just scroll down and you'll be having the chat completions. Select it and just go to quick start and just change the code to Python. So this is basically the code that we'll be making use of. So just copy this and just create a new file in Visual Studio Code or any editor. I'll have it as new.py and paste it, and here we'll be passing our API key. And before that, we will be installing two packages. One is going to be Flask and another one is going to be OpenAI. So Flask is used to create the REST API endpoint. So it's going to be pip space install OpenAI space Flask. All right, and these packages are getting installed. That's amazing. And now we need to get the OpenAI API key. So OpenAI API key is paid, like you need to buy credits before using it. So for that, you'll be having this page, right? Click on your profile and select your profile. Here we'll be having the API keys and create new secret key and just name it. Select the project and create secret key. Copy this, don't share it to anyone. If you want to delete it, you can just delete it, up to you. So now go to the code, and here we'll be having OpenAI, right? So just enter, and it's going to be API underscore key equals, here you need to paste your OpenAI API key like this. And I'm just hard coding the API key over here since this is just a demo purpose. So in better way, you can just have it in a .env file as an environment variable. All right, so write a one sentence bedtime story. This is going to be my prompt. Everything is fine. I will just clear the console, and for running it, it's going to be Python space new.py. Hope you're having Python installed on your system. So if you don't have, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. And as you can see, we got the response. So we are printing this completion choices message. If you want, you can just print the completion or choices alone and see what are the other metadata that you are getting. So now we are done with the first half. Next thing is, we'll be using Flask to create a endpoint, and we'll be sending this particular input from Postman and getting the response, which you can just plug it in your front-end app. All right. So we will begin by importing the Flask package. So it's going to be from Flask import. It's going to be capital F Flask, comma request. And we'll be having the JSONify. All right, these are the things we are going to import. And next, we'll be creating our Flask variable. So we can name that as app equal to capital F Flask. And inside that, we need to have underscore underscore name underscore underscore. And this is fine. We will just have the client, which is the OpenAI variable. Let that be outside. So just come to the next line. It's going to be at, we need to put this Flask variable app dot route, and within circular bracket we need to specify the path. So let's just have it as generate, something like this. And next, we need to specify the type of operation. So in our case, it's going to be of type post. So we'll be having methods equal to, within square bracket single quote, we need to have the type as post. That's it. Now come to the next line. We need to have a name for our endpoint. So it's going to be a function name define. Let me have it as just generate. That's it. And a colon over here. Now, basically, we will be getting the request from Postman. For example, from Postman's request body, we will be sending it as a JSON. And from that, we need to get it over here inside our code. So for that, we'll be having data equal to request, which one we imported from Flask, and it's going to be dot get underscore JSON. All right, it needs to be something like this. And next line, it's going to be prompt equal to data dot get, and inside that it's going to be prompt. So basically we will be having a JSON and the key name is going to be prompt. So we will be sending that. With the help of this code, this prompt variable will have the input prompt that we will be sending. So this will have that, and we need to send this particular prompt over here rather than sending this. This will have the prompt. All right, so that's prompt. And we can even have a condition to check. For example, if there is no prompt, we can just like throw error. We can just like say prompt is not present or something like that. We'll just return JSONify, which is also like imported by us, curly brackets. It's going to be error, and it's going to be like prompt is required. That's it. And we can just have a status as 400, which is the error status over there. And now just indent this inside the function. So it's going to be something like this. And here we are having the model name, just GPT-4o. If you want, you can change it. And messages. And here is the important part. Rather than hard coding this, just delete this fully. And we are having this variable, right? So we can just specify that over here. It's going to be prompt. That's it. Now we are good. And next we need to send back this response, because earlier we were just console logging, right? Now we need to send this as a response back. So for that, what you can do is at the end of this particular thing, you can just come here. Next line, make sure that it's aligned inside the function. Be careful with the indentation. It's going to be return the same JSONify and curly bracket. Within double quotes, it's going to be response and colon. And we can just basically copy this and put it inside. Just copy this, put it inside. That's it, and remove the print statement. So we're having this function and everything is done. Now we need to just have our main function, all right? Main function, and start our Flask. So just come outside of the function. It's going to be if underscore underscore name, just denoting this is the main function. So this is going to be the starting point, all right? Underscore underscore main underscore underscore colon, and it's going to be app.run. That's it. So now we will be hitting this path. So you can even have a try catch block, like catching the error in case if you want to have it. I just left it because it's just, you know, a small piece of code. Saving it, and let's just run it. So it has started. This is going to be our local host path. So you can just copy it. By default, it starts at port 5000. All right. So I'll just go here to Postman, paste it, and it's going to be of operation post. So change it to post and copy this path also and put it over here. Next, it's going to be body raw. This changes to JSON, not text, and curly bracket. And now we need to have a key named prompt like this. So the reason why we are having that is because in our code we have used this. So this value that we are giving over here needs to match with this key, okay? So both of them need to be matching. And here we will be specifying our input prompt. So I'll just go with give me 3 lines poem, something like this. Just go with this particular prompt, and I guess now we are good. Let me just send it. So as you can see, we have got the response, all right? So we are having this key like this one, response, and then we are sending our particular message.content. And this is the 3 lines. This is line 1, line 2, and line 3. Do check the playlist of my channel. There are a lot of videos in programming, OpenAI, Gemini AI, APIs, and other AI tools. Check the playlist. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.